Welcome back to White Knight. I think I'm done exploring this room for the moment. Except, of course, I need to do something with Selena's spirit here, but I'm not sure what to do with it at the moment. So, there's two ways I can go, either through the door or out back into the hallway. Let's check out the door first. Because this just leads back to the hallway. And I think there's a lot of ghosts around here. The old man probably did a lot, but he paid the price. These traces were the putrid remains of darkness. Yeah. I've seen lots of that stuff around, just... like, black... I guess just corruption. William Vesper's Diary, Excerpt 6, November 21st, 1929. Tonight, I again woke up with a start. It felt like there was a weight on my chest. The shadows seemed to condense more and more because of the hatred, her hatred. That wrench will never leave me in peace. I tried to turn on the light, but the fuses tripped once again. As I was reaching for the matchbox I keep under my pillow, I felt... dear God, I felt the tip of her nails on my arm. I screamed and fell out of bed. Then I remembered the matches I keep in the pockets of my pajamas, as the darkness that were lurking below the bed started crawling along my legs. I scratched the match, and it felt as if the room started to inflate, returning to its original size. I couldn't sleep anymore. I went to town. Once again, I had to do something. But these moments of peace are getting shorter and shorter. A portrait of William. His natural sadness had turned into despair. William as a child, unaware of the darkness expecting him. August 28th, 1904. A new Vesper on Earth. William, my son, I want to be your pride. These brand new science books had just arrived from Germany. This hand-drawn portrait of a young man was unexpectedly delicate. Another portrait of a young man, soft and realistic. An impressive collection of astronomy books. William Vesper's Diary, Excerpt 17, May 16th, 1928. Mother's birthday was yesterday. She harassed me all night. Her insect-like voice and insults drove me crazy. Then, as I was sleeping, the beating, the scratching. Where were you, Luna? You've been gone for nights. I jumped out of bed, took the car. In town, I saw that lonely girl stumbling on the sidewalk. Her hair was black, a color I abhor. I opened the car door. She was drunk and chilled to the bone, and got in. The knife was beneath my seat, so I didn't have the strength to do it. So I brought her back here. As I write this, she is tied in Mother's favorite seat. Fear has made her dirty, has made her dirty it already. I don't know where to start. After putting on my mask and a suitable outfit, I started cutting her forearm and thighs. Blood flowed. I felt nauseous and walked out to puke. It wasn't enough. Luna didn't react. Meanwhile, Mother and the Choir of Shadows kept mocking at my defeat. Wicked child. Shame to your blood. Bullshit. I will show you. Yep, as if there was any doubt before, he is definitely the murderer. The serial killer. Luna didn't react. He is trying to do some sort of a ritual. Is this to look at the portrait or something on the ground? Oh, the ground. Someone took it out on these psychology books. Vesper Textile Factory was apparently an important business. Oh, Jesus. Can I close that fucking door? Oh, Jesus. No. I thought a ghost was about to come out of there. I actually felt the knock in the controller vibration, by the way, which made it extra creepy. Some untouched food. Someone ate here recently. William Vesper's Diary, Excerpt 18, May 19th, 1928. I was studying an Amerindian? Yeah, I guess you pronounce it that way. Amerindian ritual sacrifice when the fuses tripped. I was grabbed and thrown to the ground by shadows, dragged to the storeroom. I managed to toggle a switch. Electricity saved me. Enraged, I grabbed the knife and the mask. I returned the girl. I sat on her to prevent her from moving, and stabbed her by following my instinct, straight in her belly, that sacred matrix. Her white skin was like a moon, reddening more and more with each new scar. Then I saw a higher art in the making. The work turning from white, the alchemical albedo, to rubido, the red work that concludes the magnum opus. It all made sense. Life. Death. The transmutation of matter. And the active tincture of the philosopher's elixir was leaking over me. Intoxicated, I poured her blood to the last drop and bathed in that body as I witnessed life flowing away from it. When I turned back, Luna's silvery eye had returned and was watching us from behind the window. The shadows were silent. I think I'm free. Blood spoke. I found a way to quiet the night. Well, if what's happening right now is any indication, then I do not think he's free. Unless that ritual perhaps only freed him for a certain amount of time. I had the feeling I could see the lights of my car. Look at this corruption all over the ground, just a black splotch. This is quite large. I don't feel like... Whoa. Okay. She's there. I don't feel like I've explored everything here yet. Like everything before this area. I feel like I've gone too far. From Henry to William. William, my son. That you would see me leaving as I am now is breaking my heart. I admire your courage, and I don't know how to thank you for seeing me as your father all the way to the end, and not as a sick man or a madman. I am tired. My fingers are shaking, and yet there are so many things I'd still like to tell you. Death is a terrible thing, William. It makes us weak, cowardly. It takes everything from us. But seeing you growing up was a constant joy for me. Thanks to you, I'm more than a man. I'm a father. I hope I have taught you enough. Do not trust your mother. Listen to her, be obedient, but never trust her. The day you turn 20, you will become the head of the Vesper factory. Although young, you will be able to rely on precious and wise advisors. Always listen to Jack Winterstone. You already know him, and you will learn to appreciate how valuable a friend he can be. You will be free then, free from her. I need to sleep. If you ever are in doubt, play the piano. I will hear you. Okay, well, I've been invited into this room, apparently, so let's go check it out. That's a fucking meat hook. Oh! Again, another vision.
This room was different. It was a dead space. A breach opened in the night. A world trying to mimic another. Memories, maybe. Suppressed memories. Sadness. Letting myself fall into a trap was starting to be a bad habit.
That smell. Cigarettes and alcohol. A bar, a club maybe. The corrupt smell of illegality, poverty and solitude. I was feeling dizzier and dizzier. I had to go out as soon as possible. Where are you? Where the hell do I go to from here? Oh. Play the piano, and Henry will hear me. Oh. Okay. Hello.
Follow me.
Rest in peace. Was that what you wanted? Such a waste. Oh god. I hope I picked the right direction.
Where are you?
Yes. I couldn't imagine her living in such misery. She had fallen so low. Whoa. Oh, that's cool. Am I back to the ostensibly real world? Actually, I don't think I am. No, I don't have any matches. Where did my matches go? Okay, so, yeah, I'm back in the room. My matches are gone. Which means I can't really look at much of what's in this room because it's kind of in darkness. Astronomy books, the moon, craters, seas, and myths. Yeah, so you're studying Luna. Are there no matches in here? These matches were covered with this ghostly residue. No use. Oh, those are the matches that I dropped. So, I guess I got wetted by ectoplasm or something. Damn it, I should have gotten the ectoplasm-free matches. Or ectoplasm-resistant. I don't really know why I'm moving this thing. What did that accomplish? The tie of the painting was weak, maybe with another blow. The painting was covering a spy hole. Things are getting murkier and murkier. What? Was something scary supposed to have just happened? I see it's illuminating like a cross on the other side, I guess. I don't see that as particularly scary. The key was waiting in the shadows, waiting for me to get it. Ooh! But a key to what? I don't know. I just want some freaking matches. Because there's a diary here and I can't get it. Yeah, too dark. Okay, back out of the hallway to find some matches, I guess. Oh wait, is this door actually locked? Maybe this door was locked, because I never tried it. Maybe that's what the key's for. I guess it's locked, or jammed? I'm not really sure. Oh. Ah, so much light. And matches. Alright, we're good. Gonna check this room out in a second, but first I wanna continue checking here. This house was too big for a single and isolated child. William Vesper's Diary, Excerpt 4. October 4th, 1916. When the moon appears at night, the shadows stop shouting. So I watch it as much as I can. I feel warmth in my body. I talk to it so it would stay. When I stop watching, it's still here in front of my eyes for a while, as if it could stay in my mind. I believe that's the reason I love night more than day. Even though the night is very dangerous because of the shadows. And because of Mother. If the moon could kill her, I might be saved, and the moon would take her place. I'm only 12, and I don't want to die like that, in the dark. He was already thinking about the moon killing his mother and all that sort of stuff when he was 12? My god. William Vesper's Diary, Excerpt 19. June 30th, 1928. The voices came back one by one. I thought I was forever free. I was so naive. That corruption runs too deep. I had to do it again tonight. There's a new girl downstairs, tied up on the slut's throne. Her hair is black as mother's. Gives me the shivers. But they justify the killing. I only touch her when I'm wearing gloves. I need to polish my approach. The first time was too brutal, too rash. Luna is subtle. She knows blood is precious. One cannot pour it out of rage or fear. The act has to be fully conscious. Using drugs, as some Indian tribes do, could amplify my perception of the ritual, but importing them will take some time. In any case, Luna is weak tonight, but she is still there, waiting, curious to see me act. There's Luna. From that hole, I could only see the moon. Could it be pure luck? William Vesper's Diary, Excerpt 23, July 8th, 1928. I drank too much tonight. I woke up in the storeroom. I was holding the knife so tightly that releasing it made me scream. I had a dream. When I was a kid, she locked me up in that room all the time. That night, that dark and moonless night, cold fingers are touching me, their nails as sharp as blades. I hear their relentless voices, swirling inside the house, and see their empty eyes. I'm 13. I start screaming. Mother opens the door and starts shouting at me. I try to escape. She pushes me back. Her glass of wine breaks in her hand. Blood flows, drops fall on the ground. A silver beam crosses the skylight and falls upon the red blood. Luna reappears fully in the sky. Mother steps back and, for the first time, I see fear on her face. She's afraid of me. I'm afraid too, but shivering from excitement. Luna. That night, I understood what your favorite wine was. The wine that is flowing in the veins of women with black hair is what makes you shine. Okay, that's it for this room. I just read this, didn't I? No, I didn't. Margaret's Diary, Excerpt 14, September 15th, 1911. I found Henry arching on his bed, naked, grasping the sheets as if they were chains. When Sarah entered, she screamed, "He's possessed!" I told her to wake up the servants and go look for Dr. Rosenthal. She was too happy to leave. I came close to Henry. In the darkness, his eyes looked like two balls of mercury, the eyes of his son. He had scars all over his chest, inflicted by his own nails. He grasped the sleeve of my gown and hissed, "There you are, whore." He dragged me towards him, towards the obscene swell of his crotch. The past and the present were one, drawing a sinister bloody line to the future. He was lost, a wrecked man, like my father. I was doomed. God had turned his back on me. Margaret's Diary, Excerpt 13, September 15th, 1911. It happened tonight, around 1 a.m. The house was quiet. Sarah had taken William to bed after dinner, and Henry had left the living room around 10 p.m., saying he was tired. I thought we were past trying to forge excuses. I was painting in my room when I heard the yell. My heart stopped. I thought it was a delusion, but the yell resonated once again. A yell of ancient fear, reaching out from the abyss. A door that I thought locked for good just slammed open in my mind. And behind it was a frightened child who thought her father was coming back from the dead to take her. I quickly pulled myself together. I went out in the hall. The yells were coming from Henry's room. William was awake and about to enter his father's room. I sent him back to his bed, despite his tears. I knew too well what was waiting inside. A huge quantity of blood. It made me feel sick. Does he mean inside of the tub? I can't see it. A broken glass. Because of a storm or a quarrel? The kind of tool a woman always needs in front of a mirror. Oh, that's probably what I need to give to Selena. It may have been Selena's lipstick, a sacred relic. Toilet paper, still waiting for its transfer to the toilets. Bottle of French perfume was probably very expensive. Some sort of goddess of fertility. The label says cyanide, not your everyday perfume. Yeah. Was Selena living here, or was it just a madman's delusion? Was I really the man in the mirror? I'd looked like a dead man. Maybe you are literally dead, that would not surprise me. Ugh, turn it back on. Unless, hold on, maybe there's something that pops up if you turn it off. Something that changes. Nope, doesn't seem like it. The chair is blocking the door, no need to ask why. Hi. Yeah. Alright, so I have to leave this way, because the other way is blocked. I'm gonna run. I want to find my way back to my save point. Which is in here? Let's save in a second. Let's do this first. I need to give her the hairbrush.
What was her story? Her beauty. Her light. They didn't match the sadness in her eyes. We were bound. She was trying to guide me, to draw me to her, like a dream which has to be dreamt just to be. She had helped me stay alive until now. This was more than enough to want her presence.
Where did she go? She kind of went through here. A secret door? Nothing here surprised me anymore. I want to go save, but... Well, let's not be stupid. I should just go save. Only thing is, it's going to leave me with one match. But it has been about 25 minutes since I've saved, so I really probably should. Oh, wait, I think I see some matches. Yeah, there's actually some matches right here, aren't there? Oh, thank God. It probably was Margaret's room. The beast's womb. Oh, Jesus. The scratches on the door. Oh, am I locked here? On that night, I was no longer a man. I was becoming a prey. I don't want to be here. Is there a light? If there is, I'm sure it doesn't work. Margaret's diary, excerpt 10. April 2nd, 1906. William grows well. He has the pale skin and the weak health of his father. I watch carefully over him. He is very quick for a 2-year-old boy. I stimulate him with all sorts of tests and experiences to elevate his soul. Turner's paintings put him in a very strong state of excitement. Bach delights him. He likes things bitter, strangely, and he looks intensely at a picture of Jesus. I try reading inside him. I try to make sure this was all worth it. Will he be strong enough to be one of the pillars of this world? God, give me the faith to fight all these doubts. This morning, I saw in his eyes a glimpse of light which reminded me of my father. His eyes, like two pits of darkness, are too deep. I don't like it. They scrutinize your soul, looking for a breach. I seized his arm to make him stop, and then I saw Henry, watching me from the doorstep. He keeps me under watch every time I'm with a kid. Margaret's Diary, Excerpt 8, August 7th, 1899. I was introduced today to the Vesper Sun, the one who would become my husband and seal the alliance between our families. Their success in the textile industry was spectacular, but I felt no vigor in that man, Henry. His blood seems rather poor. He is not tall, and had his tailor not been so efficient, he would have no elegance. But our fortune is past, and we need these people to regain our influence. People only respect money now. Through this alliance, the Vesper will enjoy our contacts within the greatest and oldest families in Boston. Their business, mired by competition and politics, will flourish even more. In many ways, I can't avoid feeling superior to that man in his loyal dog eyes. His voice barely covered the whisper of the sea. The wedding will be celebrated in a couple of months. I'm not really excited. But if my flesh can be the torch of our resurrection, I gladly consent to this sacrifice. Margaret was a bad memory even for that house. Ooh. Oh, I need to turn the light on, don't I? Mm-hmm. Hold on, what about this door? Oh, Jesus. Yeah, I didn't think so. Light switch, light switch, light switch. Whoa. Okay. Margaret's Diary, Excerpt 17. July 6th, 1913. I paint all the time. Ideas come by themselves, and I make the paintings as fast as I can to cope for their urgency. Sometimes it feels like it's not me painting anymore, but another Margaret, more instinctive, more animal. What's happening to me? Sometimes, I feel like I slept and I wake up looking at someone else's work. My painting bears the marks. The movement is visible in the thick paste. The hues are darker than they used to be. I even noticed small cuts in the canvas. When I leave my workshop, it feels like my eyesight is better, as if it is craving for light, as if it was deprived of it while I was painting. I forgot to mention Henry was more and more, has more and more attacks. Sarah wants me to call the vicar, Hopper. Maybe his coming death has a role to play in my rebirth. Is it the price to pay to be a free woman? Each second was like a victory, but not necessarily for me. The snakehead reminded me of the original sin. Ooh, matches. Okay, yeah, just rock on your own, lovely chair. It's not creepy at all. The storm was coming. More darkness for us. Margaret's paintings reveal a true artistic talent. Alright, there appears to be no light switch in this room, so I guess it's gotta be over here. Whoa, did I just see a shadow? Oh, yes. Oh, and there's a lamp. That old kind of lamp had no switch. Wait, something just popped up to push. What was that? I need both my hands free to do that. To push what? I don't even know what that is. Well, either way, I suppose it's irrelevant at the moment. Where am I? I've, like, totally lost my sense of place. Where did I just... Okay, this is where I came from, yes. What, no, what, huh? Okay. Note to self, sabotage. Electric light kills the shadows. These dark doubles of Margaret figured it out, and now they regularly sabotage any electrical apparatus so that the wiring trip in the middle of the night. The wirings trip in the middle of the night. With this cruel game, they are trying to wear me out, and it is working. I almost no longer sleep. An offering of books had been made to that body. Oh shit, I didn't even realize there was a body there. There is. Let's give her a wide berth. Margaret's Diary, excerpt 20? August 26th, 1913. Henry died today. His last word was for William, whom he called in a whisper. He asked Sarah to play a jazz record before he passed away. Nothing would surprise me anymore. After a number of meetings with the managing board, I will officially assume duties at the Vesper manufacturer. I already noticed a number of issues in the management of the company, all linked to Henry's romantic nature. I think I can clear most of them and improve the benefits. We will change the strategy and prepare for the future. Vesper should not be the brand of the poor anymore. Margaret's Diary, excerpt 7. April 12th, 1898. Today was my birthday. I have been in this world for 17 years. It has been 1 year and a half since we buried the man who gave me life. This thing which had been living with us was filth dressed in flesh. Everything is better now. I spent the day looking at our family archives, enjoying the greatness of my ancestors, leaders, often sacrificed for the greater good. At that time, the blood of men was still untainted. Nowadays, it has gone sour like milk left under the sun. That is what killed Father. And so we never forget it. I have to paint the beauty of ancient times. I have to portray them as an example for generations to come. I still have hope for our family. Sooner or later, I will bear another Venter cross. The classes of Mrs. DeLange are teaching me a lot. She says I'm one of the finest painters in Boston. Showing her the blue veins under the skin of my arm, I reminded her that the Venter Cross excellence was carried by the women's blood first and foremost. I could see a balcony on the other side. Does that mean I can go out to the balcony at some point, maybe? Oh god, I don't like this camera angle. I don't like the camera angles that don't show me the ghost. It could be getting up right now. Alright, so I need to put... Yeah, I need to do a bunch of stuff, and I need the light for that. I need to get to the switch. Yeah, I can't do any of this stuff while holding a match. Alright, there she is. God damn it, the switch is right fucking in front of her, isn't it? There it is. She's gonna get up though, isn't she? Oh god. She's getting up. She's getting up. Oh yeah. Okay, I guess she's very tired. She doesn't want to step too far away from the bed. Thank god. Can I just banish her, like... Did I just banish her? I wonder if that's Selena. Or... Actually, that might be Margaret's body who's been dug up. We did see a bunch of... caskets, right? Yeah. Alright, did that get rid of her? Yeah, she's gone. But... permanently? Or... Young Margaret. A sweet face pinned over a storm. Alright, now we can push this thing. Okay, not quite yet. Hold on, can I examine the body? Am I actually pointing it at the body correctly? No, I'm not. There we go. Alright, hold on. Before I use another match, let me do this. Body. I don't think I can examine the body specifically, just the books that are offered. Is this new? No, sabotage, no. Read that before. The body was unrecognizable, it's sight unbearable. Alright, so I don't know who it is. Margaret? Selena? Oh, why would I want to turn that off? Dear God, no. See, is this useful at all? I need a light in there. I don't think this helps. But I'll try it. Oh, where the hell am I? What? Okay, she's apparently there. You know, I think I'm gonna see what's through this door, because I kind of feel like I want to save. Locked. Oh. Alright. So that's useless. So what else do I need to do with the light, then? I mean, opening this is pointless at the moment, because I can't actually go through it. I've read those things. I've got to... I must have to point it over. Back at the room where I came from. Is this something I can pull? Oh, it is. Ah, let the light in. Okay. Don't see her. That's a good thing. So what did I need? I needed the chest. So let's get the chest open. The key to the door. What the fuck? Son of a bitch. She sabotaged it, I guess. Can I turn it back on? Oh, come on! Really? I tried to do the thing, and then I got stuck in an animation, and then I was dead. Alright. I'll be right back. Okay, let's try this again. And before picking up the key, let's look at the other things. These books were covering the modern evolutions of fashion. Looks like that's it. The books and the key. Alright, light's gonna go out. And we run away from her. To the door. And I saw a light switch, I believe. Of course it wasn't working. Can I shut the door? Yeah, let's just shut that. I feel better. Ooh, okay. I want to find a save point. Before anything else, I just want to find a save point. Ooh, a piano. I'm going to be playing that soon. There's gotta be a save point here. Let me try to find it. What in the f... What the hell? Alright, there's a lot to this room. And a bunch of matches, too, so I guess they intend for you to stay here a very long time. Can I start the fire, or does it need wood? Needed to find some wood, okay. I don't think that's related to saving, is it? Is there really nowhere to save here? It's been quite a while since the last save. Oh, wait a minute. Wait. Did I just see... Oh. The piano was begging me to play the music that was floating in the air. Maybe this is considered a save? Hmm. She's not thinking of jumping over, is she? Oh, God.
What was she trying to do when she jumped? To put an end to a dream she seemed sentenced to live again and again? To give me proof she needed me? Just like her, I wanted to escape. But I wanted to escape with her. And in one piece.
Hello? Do I have to watch her jump again and again? God. Here's some wood. I do! I don't want to watch her jump again and again, that's horrible. Alright, two might be enough wood. I really just want a save point, though. Like, I desperately want a save point. Please let me save. I don't want to watch her die anymore. That's depressing. See if two wood is enough. Need more wood, damn it. Alright, one more wood's probably enough. Look, I see like an African something tribal mask whatever on the wall. Can I just burn that? I know it's priceless art, but at this point I don't really care. Okay, hallway is no good. Although, if I go into the hallway, I can go back to the save point. Is this? Oh, here we go, here's a save point. Alright, whew, I feel better now. Much better. Alright, well, I think I will end this episode here. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.